This is Girl 4, Lured, a Maya Gray FBI suspense thriller, Book 4, written by Molly Black, narrated by Rosanna Pilcher. Chapter 1. Maya stood in the middle of the barn, feeling a brief note of relief as she stared down at the woman on the stretcher. The rest of an FBI team stood around her, clearing the area, making sure that there were no traps or bombs. She'd been sent to recover the Moonlight Killer's most recent hostage, leaning in close to the stretcher, desperate to hear the message that the young woman there had brought from her sister. Katya's words came out as little more than a whisper. "He has a tattoo on his forearm, a snake crushing an armadillo under a full moon." Those words sent a shock through Maya as she realized that for the first time, she had something beyond the most basic physical information on the Moonlight Killer, the man who had taken her sister and 11 other women hostage. 8 in total now. He was only holding 8 women. Maya had secured the release of 3 of them by solving the murders he sent her off to investigate, while one had found herself killed for trying to escape. That last thought filled her with fear for her sister. Megan had taken a huge risk trying to get this information to Maya. If the Moonlight Killer realized what she'd done, then even that might be enough to get her killed. That was why Maya knew that she couldn't share it with her superiors, not yet. The same way that she hadn't shared with them the real identity of the man who'd kidnapped so many women. She couldn't take any chance of the information slipping out, and the Moonlight Killer heard far too much. Talking of her boss, Deputy Director Harris was currently standing just a few paces away, looking over at Maya with obvious expectation. The deputy director was an avuncular middle-aged man with slightly soft features, a shaved head designed to hide his bald spot, and an expensive suit under his tactical jacket.
"Well?"
He wanted to know what the message had been, but Maya knew that she couldn't just come out and say it. The deputy director had jumped on clues before, pushing forward in ways that had gotten people hurt, that had gotten her sister hurt. More than that, though, Maya was increasingly convinced that the Moonlight Killer was listening to every word that she said. She had to be careful now what she said aloud, and to whom. "She just confirmed that my sister is alive and well, trapped together with the others," Maya said. It was a lie, but it was the kind of lie that was plausible enough that Harris might not double-check.
"We knew that."
Harris looked a little deflated. It felt wrong lying to her boss like that. It was wrong. If it came out, it could cost Maya her job, or worse. It could see her face charges for obstruction of justice. Yet, honestly, Maya didn't know what else to do. The alternative was far, far worse.
"Still, we have something," Harris said, looking brighter. "If Katya here really believes that she knows where she was brought here from, we might actually have a chance to catch the man who's doing all this. We need to get back and start working on this at once."
Back on the fourth floor of the FBI headquarters, Maya was getting a horrible feeling of deja vu. Out in the bullpen of the fourth floor, surrounded by desks, Harris was standing in the midst of a large group of agents with a board set out in the middle, a map on that board. A plan was starting to form there, and Maya knew another raid building up when she saw one.
"We managed to get some information from the hostage," Harris said. "We've also had forensics back on one of the early postcards that the kidnapper sent. No personal traces, but there were microscopic plant spores that can help us narrow an area down."
Around him, the other agents looked on as if they hadn't listened to all this before, as if they'd simply forgotten the 2 previous raids Harris had organized, and the consequences. As if they hadn't been there for the planning of the attempt to catch the Moonlight Killer when he released his first hostage, or for the raid on an empty building that had seen SWAT team members walk into Claymore Mines, or for the second raid, which has seen her sister systematically beaten by the Moonlight Killer after it had failed, and photographs sent to Maya as proof. Or maybe they didn't care. Agent Reyes stood near Harris, younger than Maya, Latino of middling height. He looked as eager as ever to play his part in catching the kidnapper. But then, he'd been one of the ones pushing for it from the start of all this. Maya didn't know if that was just the desire to get all this done, or if he wanted the glory of catching this guy all to himself. Either way, it was dangerous.
"We believe we have a location," Harris said, pointing to a specific spot.
He moved over to aerial photographs set out on the board to the side of the map. They showed a building, some kind of wooden cabin, obviously custom built.
This is the location we will be focusing on with our raid. If we strike quickly, I believe that we can capture this.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.